Hello viewers, we are seeing Angular JS 2 tutorial. So last sessions we saw the overview of the complete architecture. So normally how the Angular JS application is building. So this is the demonstration which I downloaded from the official website. So this is the project that is provided from official. I shared already the link. Just go through my Angular 2 playlist and get the link. So today I going to show you some interesting topics related with the components. So before going that, I generally explain you. Okay, so normally component, what it will helps you. So a component is a place to structurize your views. So views in a sense. So here I have a my app. So this attribute, so this is the HTML picker. So this if I add the my app, this is called as a selector. So normally this so this particular tag we are customizing, we called this as a component. If you apply the my app, so my app where it will represent is actually this. So whatever the template which is under this my app selector, so this will be default, it will be placed under over here. So that is what. So so on the runtime, so you no need to create a template on every time copy paste in the page. So that's what normally Angular 2 helps you to create the component, and you can use that component wherever you want. Yes, so today I going to show you some features in the component and how we can use the flexible way. So how we can use it in a strongly typed, I going to show you. So this example, I just created one component, the named as my app selector. So here I have a basic template in that I have a h1 tag with hello the name. So hello name is, this is Angular 2 tutorial. So that is what all about here. So it's displaying over here. So today I going to go a little bit extend and create something new. So let's this is actually so it will be like this. So normally this is the component for the class app component. So if you create the component over here, you can declare the values in the class. So let's go on to create one more value. So name and version, something like this. Okay, so here I can go ahead and add the property versions, something like 2.0. okay, so just to save that, if you go the browser, automatically it will be synchronized. Yeah, so it's got synchronized. So if you change your to the version 3, okay, it's got ideal time. So now see automatically, if you refresh the browser, yes. So it's take bit time to synchronize. Okay, fine, that is due to my system. Okay, so here I can able to add the more property in the template. So you can pause the value over here. So but today I don't want to add the property, something like every time the name, version, and that value I need to assign here. So for that, something I going to show you something different. So I going to create the own property class. It is called as a strongly typed. So using that property, I going to assign the values. So let me show that. Okay, what I going to do, I going to export one more class. So I going to create a class. Okay, class something like app details. Okay, something like this. So here I going to set the property name. This is a string variable. Okay, and one more version. This is the number. Okay, okay, so now I declare the property. So normally if you are a developer, so if you are basically from the Java or C sharp. So you guys will create the properties by using get and setter method. But this is what the AngularJS this class will helps you to make your application strongly typed. So here what I created the one variable with the type. I mentioned the type data type as a string and the version. So now I going to use that into my template. Okay, so how I going to use that? Simply I going to declare names thing like app. Okay, app dot version. So here I going to remove this and I going to mention that app actually holds app details. Okay, the name is Angular Angular 2 Go Free Lancer Tut. Okay, and the version is 2. Okay, let's save this. Okay, so everything is done now. Just go to the browser. Yes, hello, Angular 2 Go Freelancer tutorial. The version is 2. So I can tell that. Okay, hello, and something like version. Okay, just say that. Okay, let's go to the browser. Okay, hello, Angular 2 Go Freelancer tutorial version 2. So this is the way to make your component more flexible by using the class strongly typed class and assign the property over here. So in a future session I going to show you how to call the services, from that how to assign the value from the services to this strongly typed class, and how this makes more dynamically. So just stay tuned my Angular 2 tutorial. I will come back with some useful tutorials series in the Angular 2. Hopes you understand. Just go through the same, just follow my tutorial from the scratch to get what I am trying to say, so and you can try better even what I am showing. So I am just taking the structure from the official website to show you exactly what Angular 2 mean to say to the world, and what the structure exactly to follow. Though I am just following the same structure to explain to you, so it will be very helpful if you follow complete series of my tutorial. You will able to handle Angular 2 application. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Please share your comments. If you have any doubts, please subscribe to your channel if you're not subscribed before. If you are using the YouTube app to watch, there is a bell symbol in my channel. Just go and click the bell symbol to get a regular notification.